Commodore, are there more Chinese ships now?
Right now in Bajo del Masinloc?
Yes.
In Bajo del Masinloc, in general, there are always four Chinese Coast Guard vessels there, the one inside the lagoon and the two vessels that are outside the lagoon. So basically, this has always been constant since 2012 until now. Four Chinese
Okay.
Coast Guards have always been guarding the Bajo del Masinloc. And in reference with the last humanitarian mission that we did, they are still the same. The number of China Coast Guard vessels remains to be constant. There are still four China Coast Guard vessels who intercepted the humanitarian mission of Coast Guard MB4.
I'm curious because I'm curious if they're increasing in number.
Well, there was a study conducted by AMTI, which was released by Greg Pauling. He had this kind of satellite images comparing the number of vessels whenever we do a supply mission in a Yunnan Shoal. And then he argued that there is more number of deployment of Chinese maritime militia and Chinese Coast Guard since 2023 up to this time whenever we do the supply mission, compared during the time of the previous administration. But again, we have to contextualize this kind of data. During the time of 2016 to 2022, besides from the fact that we are not transparent about what's happening, but things are much more easier for China to tell us to keep away from a Yunnan Shoal or to hold our vessels away from BRP Sierra Madre. But this time around, under this administration, President Bongbong Marcos was able to successfully challenge those red lines. Before, in the Yunnan Shoal, whenever we do the resupply mission, Coast Guard vessels will just stay in Sabina Shoal and will just allow the entire supply boat to do their voyage on their own. But for this administration, under the leadership of Eduardo Anyo at the National Task Force, we were able to break the 12 nautical mile mark red line that they're saying. And every time we do the resupply operation, we can already come close to a Yunnan Shoal. The same thing here in Bajo del Masinloc. Before, Coast Guard vessels and BFAR vessels cannot go near Bajo del Masinloc. But the last humanitarian mission, we came close as near as 600 yards. So what I'm saying is that during the previous administration, from 2016 to 2022, China doesn't need to flex their muscles because we are already, allowing them to maintain those kind of red lines. But in this administration, for President Bongbong Marcos to assert our sovereign rights and sovereignty in these waters, they need to deploy more China Coast Guard vessels and Chinese maritime militia to prevent us from getting near those shoals.
Okay, well, that's very good work. Actually, that's a big change, I would have to say.
Yes, those red lines have already been challenged and broken and proven to be something that is just a threat. The only disadvantage part on the People's Republic of China is that they are deploying more vessels. But again, this is our intention for us to keep on pushing the Chinese maritime forces, whether they are Coast Guard or Chinese maritime militia, for them to be able to respect our own position that a Yunnan Shoal and Bajo del Masinloc falls within our own exclusive economic zone. And this has always been the objective of this administration, to once again assert our position and make them realize that they are not really in control of all these shoals.
I'm curious, Commodore, is it possible for the Philippines to also station ships in Scarborough Shoal? Do we have that capacity?
Well, Ms. Karen, we have been since February 1, when General Eduardo Anyo issued a directive for the Philippine Coast Guard and the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources to maintain presence in Bajo del Masinloc. We call this a rotational deployment between the two institutions. Coast Guard will be deploying and then eventually BFAR. So far, we have been very successful in at least making sure that at any one time, there will be a government vessel in Bajo de Masinloc who can look after the welfare and security of the Filipino fishermen.
Okay. I'm curious, moving on to a slightly different topic, Kalayaan Islands, I know that there's a budget to actually rehabilitate, right, and improve the structures there. Is that correct?
Well, it's not just for this administration. Even during the time of President Duterte, he has supported the renovation of the runway and the construction of the port there. So all of this are already on the works. And this administration has also been supportive in maintaining that kind of renovation, particularly in those facilities that house the Coast Guard and even the Armed Forces of the Philippines.
So I'm curious, is there any kind of renovation going on now?
Well, the runway was already fairly renovated, and also the shelter port. Those are the projects, again, that was initiated and funded by President Duterte.
Okay, now we are seeing Balikatan exercises. Will there be similar exercises with the Philippine Coast Guard?
Well, for this Balikatan exercise this year, this is the first time that the Philippine Coast Guard vessels will be participating. But in the previous years, only Coast Guard personnel have been attending some of the activities in Balikatan. So this time around, as what Colonel Lohico has mentioned, Philippine Coast Guard vessels will be joining the maritime exercise of the Balikatan.
All right. Well, on that note, thank you so much for joining me today, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Karen, and mabuhay po kayo.